Hi, Nick. Wouldn't the heart be working very hard trying to get oxygen to supply the body? Exactly right. And hi, Nick, I don't know if that was you that asked this question originally. I hope that, again, my fumbling through the slides today was not too circular, but the circularity is a real issue. There are two issues going on, and we don't really know clearly which issue is the most important. We do know that we're going to continue to use steroid anti-inflammatories when somebody gets to significant acute respiratory distress syndrome. We just don't know the potential role of antivirals. But yes, that's exactly what's going on. The heart is working very hard. It beats 60 to 80, 90 times a minute. And when you start getting into ARDS, acute respiratory distress, that will jack up to 110, 120 times a minute. So it's working harder with less oxygen to work with. So big, big deal. And again, it's the heart and our ability to breathe are spiraling out of control. That's what's causing the problem. I don't know if anybody heard Boris Johnson's statement after coming back out of that. And he said there was a 48-hour period. I had a couple of nurses who were watching my ability to breathe and making adjustments every few minutes. That saved me. And that's what is saving people all over the world right now. Brave healthcare providers who know that they're not being protected adequately in most cases from this virus, but still committed to watching these people when they're going through this spiraling. The heart doesn't have enough oxygen to pump, but it's still got to pump harder, and whether or not it's going to make it through that time period. So again, major, major bravery and contribution by our intensive care healthcare folks. Continue to get great feedback regarding the webinars. And here's why. You know, on the internet, when you hear a webinar, you expect for somebody to try to sell you something. We're not doing that. We're trying to tell you something. People are coming in with their labs from Quest, inflammation panel, OGTT, insulin survey response, and then they're finding out, do I have inflammation? Do I have insulin resistance? And where does that fit in terms of other folks? We're getting ready to start one for CIMT as well. So again, people are really excited about finding out their own status. Looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.